And as WISN 12 News, Colleen Henry reports, police hope the conversations will help unravel the motive behind her murder.
A piece of us is gone. One that can never be replaced.
At Jennifer Sebena's funeral, fellow officer Tracy Burbach spoke of Sebena's impact on the Wauwatosa Police Department.
Most of all, Jen had become one of us, part of our family.
Police say in the weeks before her death, Jennifer Sebena confided in Burbach about problems at home. She told Burbach her husband Benjamin struggled with post-traumatic stress after two tours of duty in Iraq and Afghanistan, where he suffered a traumatic brain injury. Newly released court records reveal details about an incident 3 weeks before her death. According to this subpoena, Sebena told Burbach her husband suffers flashbacks when he thinks he's in Afghanistan or Iraq. That in December, he was pointing a handgun at her head during one of his flashbacks. Sebena told Burbach the flashbacks occur more frequently at night. And because she worked the night shift, she was concerned about her husband harming himself and never knew what state he would be in when she came home from work.
Jen had the personality people gravitated towards. She had quick wit, never spoke negatively of anyone.
Police say when they arrested Benjamin Sebena, he told them he'd stalked his wife on a number of occasions when she was working, that he and his wife were texting in the hours before her death. Now, police have subpoenaed records from the couple's two phones to use in his prosecution. They've requested cell phone movements, call histories, and the content of all text messages in the weeks before Sabina's death. Neither Officer Burbach nor the Wauwatosa Police Department would talk about these subpoenas, but a detective told the court that the cellular service company handed over 10 pages of text messages they intend to use to prosecute Benjamin Sebena. In Wauwatosa, Colleen Henry, WISN 12 News.